o'clock Central Daylight Central Standard Time. Pretty soon it'll be Central Daylight Time. Ball two, no strikes now to Bill. That's a fly ball deep to left. Back she goes, back she goes, back she goes. And it's caught out there by Dimmel, and the ball game is over. Oh, man. It looked like it had a chance to be high on the wall. As a matter of fact, it looked like it had a chance to go into that basket out there. But Mike Dimmel made the move back, stood on the warning track, shoulders brushing the vines out there, and pulls it in, and this ball game is all over. Oh, man. No runs, no hits, no errors, and a man left. Final score, St. Louis 3, the Chicago Cubs 2. For St. Louis, 3 runs, 13 hits, no errors, 7 men left on. For the Cubs, 2 runs, 12 hits, no errors, 13 men left on. No wonder they lose the ball games. You just can't leave that many on base. Bruno the winner, the loser Moore. The time of the game was 3:28. Paid attendance today, 12,825. I'm Jack Brickhouse. That's it from Wrigley Field today. Our next televised game will be between the Cubs and the St. Louis Cardinals tomorrow. Our telecast begins with the leadoff man at 1:15. Our participating advertisers in today's game were Chicago Pontiac Dealers Association, Miller High Life, True Value Hardware Stores, your Union 76 dealers, the Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Zenith and your Zenith dealers, the Yellow Pages, Toyota Motor Sales USA, and your Chicagoland Toyota dealers. This telecast was directed by Arnie Harris, our sports editor Jack Rosenberg. Cubs lost the ball game 3-2 in 14. This has been a WGN Television 9 sports presentation.
Call a radio station that gives you a morning of Larry Lujack, plus news and weather.
That's my favorite.
That plays more of Chicago's most popular hits.
Quite frankly, it's my favorite.
What would you call a radio station that gives you a chance to win a $75,000 home?
Our favorite. Oh.
Call it your favorite. We call it WLS.